Conventional home loans. Will you spend your lifetime paying for a traditional house? Are you considering a 30-year fixed-rate conventional loan for your home purchase? In this video, we'll break down the pros and cons in order to help you make an informed decision. In the following example, we used an online calculator at https://www.mortgagecalculator.org. Let's say the terms of your proposed loan are as follows. The agreed-on price of the house is $400,000. Down payment, $80,000, which is 20% of the agreed-on price. After your down payment, you finance the remaining amount of $320,000. The loan term is 30 years. The current fixed interest rate for September 2024 is 5.98%. Let's take a closer look at this scenario. Now, what are the benefits of choosing this loan? First, lower monthly payments. A 30-year loan term stretches your payments over a long period, making each monthly payment more affordable. For this loan, your total monthly payment will be approximately $2,339.45. Second, there's interest rate stability. Your 5.98% interest rate is locked in for the entire 30 years, so you're protected from market rate increases. Third, you may benefit from tax-deductible interest. Depending on your financial situation and tax laws, you could deduct mortgage interest from your taxable income, especially in the early years. Also, the loan offers flexibility with payments. With lower monthly payments, you have the option to pay more toward your principal when possible, giving you flexibility in your financial planning. What are some cons of a 30-year fixed-rate loan? Yes, it's important to weigh the cons also. Over 30 years, you'll face higher overall interest payments. In fact, you'll pay $369,201.62 in interest by the end of the loan. Another downside is the slower equity buildup. Early payments go mostly toward interest, meaning it takes longer to build equity in your home. Plus, a 30-year mortgage means you're committing to a long-term debt, potentially limiting your financial flexibility for other investments or major life plans. And finally, although your rate is fixed, at 5.98%, it's higher than historical lows, meaning you'll pay out more money in interest compared to borrowers with lower rates. The good news? Because your down payment is 20%, PMI, or private mortgage insurance, is not required, saving you additional costs. By the loan payoff date in August 2054, you'll have made 360 payments totaling $842,201.62. This includes $81,000 in property taxes, $72,000 in homeowners insurance, and $369,201.62 in interest. Your first mortgage payment breaks down like this: $1,594.67 for September 2024 goes towards interest. $319.78 goes towards the principal. After adding in $225 for monthly property taxes and $200 for home insurance, your full monthly payment totals $2,339.45. $319,680.22 is the balance owed after one payment is made. For February 2043, $955.13 goes towards interest. $959.32 goes towards principal. $190,705.87 is now the balance. This is the first payment going towards the principal balance, that is greater than the amount that goes towards interest. For August 2054, $9.49 goes towards interest. $1,904.96 goes towards principal. Your mortgage is now paid in full. All you have to do now is continue to pay property taxes. Deciding on a 30-year fixed-rate mortgage is about balancing your monthly affordability with the long-term costs. Whether it's the right choice for you depends on your financial goals and plans. As of 2024, most consumers cannot afford a traditional house, as the increase in gas prices has caused the price of almost all goods and services to increase. You are more likely to afford a tiny house, move to or built on unrestricted land. It is even better if the land is family-owned. Please like, comment and subscribe to the Affordable Alternative Housing channel. Thanks for watching.